long-awaited first impressions on my pair of Knicks boots. I'll give you a little bit of information on my Knicks boots in particular. These are Rangers, and I ordered them in a rough out. What is this? Toe and heel, and with a smooth upper, and I think it actually turned out really nice, as you guys can see. I mean, of course, this is just personal taste with a little bit of durability. That is the whole reason of getting roughed out, is it's more abrasion and cut resistant than if you were just to have it completely smooth. As well, if it does get scuffed up or damaged, it doesn't show it as well as smooth. Like if you have a cut or abrasion in smooth leather, I'm sure as any of you know, it shows up really well, and on rough it doesn't. And so I really want to get that primarily for the resistance to abrasion. And kind of these Rangers slightly modified, because when I got the original test fit, they were quite high arched, and I didn't like as much arch that there was in it, so I had them take that down a little bit, and now it's a lot flatter and I like it a lot more. But those are pretty much the only two customizations I've made to the standard Ranger. And so, like I was saying, this is a first impressions, so these are still in the break-in period. That being said, I did wear them around the woods for a few hours today, and so I do have some points and I can talk about them a little bit. But like I said, they're still in break-in, so they were a little painful, of course. I'm still trying to get them to fully fit correctly, and that's to be expected with any Knicks boot or any custom boot that you're breaking. So, as I mentioned with the rough out, I really like it. You guys can barely even tell, well hopefully, I don't know, maybe you can, but I can barely tell that this has any dirt or really is at all any wear on these, and they actually did go through quite a bit, and they brushed up against a lot of rose bushes. And like I said, there's no scratches, nothing. It looks completely like it did yesterday when I pulled them out of the box. In addition, these boots, they probably look pretty big on camera, and to me they look pretty big, but I actually find that they're really small when like wearing them. I find that they're pretty lightweight and small and really maneuverable. I'm actually wearing them throughout the woods, and I did quite a bit of things through quite a few scenarios, like walking through creek beds and different things, to just kind of get a feel of how they handled slopes and just generally how they handled walking. And I thought, like I said, due to the fact of that lightweight feel and that lightweight durability, that kind of I was really able to do quite a few things, even in their break-in mode, where they're not quite as loose. As far as break-in does go, I haven't really found them to be actually that painful, or not as painful as I expected. There certainly is a little bit, but I really haven't found much. Well, onto fitment, that's kind of what Knicks prides themselves on, and the fitment is very good on these boots. I haven't had any complaint. They're a lot like a Kydex sheath. There, it takes a little bit to get your foot in there, but once it's locked in, I have found that it's just absolutely perfect. Like I said, it's a lot like a Kydex sheath. It's like molded to your foot. So I've really been impressed with the fitment on these. And once again, it definitely, I think, meets the Knicks boot standard of being really top-notch. But once again, I still need to fully break them in before I can really talk about how awesome the fitment is. Other than that, they've been really awesome boots, and I love the product, but I will say the customer service has certainly been interesting, and as I mentioned in the very beginning of the video, this has been a long-awaited first impressions, because I've had to wait over 6 months to get these boots, and I've found that Knicks boots, I'm not sure how they work in the continental U.S., they're probably faster down there, but I found that they are not very good at handling anyone outside the continental U.S., such as Alaska, where I'm at. And the shipping has been very slow, and so it took them about 6 months to make the boots, and took them about a week to get up here. So, as I was saying, the customer service, they're very friendly people, but like I said, I don't know how well equipped they are to deal with people outside of the 48 states. So that has been kind of a problem, and honestly one of the biggest reasons why I wouldn't order from them again is just because it just took so long, and yeah, I really don't prefer to wait a huge amount of time, like 6 to 5 months for boots. But like I said, the product is absolutely fantastic so far. I will be doing a review on them later once I have even more use on them and once they're broken in, that I can really give a more detailed analysis of how good they are and how good the fitment is and how well they've held up. But like I said, so far I really like the product, and I think they did a really good job.